Okay, so let's figure out if we have a function given a graph. So up on the board, I have a few different examples of some different graphs. And we're being asked, are they a function or not? And then also to state the domain and range of them. So when it comes to figuring out if a graph is a function, the main test that is used the most often when it comes to the graph here is called the vertical line test. So the vertical line test essentially says, if I can draw a straight vertical line anywhere on my graph, I can draw as many straight lines on my graph, and as long as it only intersects at one point, then we're good. So if it crosses at more than 1, 2, 3, 4, it doesn't really matter. If it's more than one time that it cuts through the graph, it is not a function. So let's start with this graph that we have over here. All right, so figuring out, is this a function, and then state the domain and range of it. So take a look at this here. So if I cut through a line anywhere on here, and if you want, you can go ahead and draw some lines anywhere on your graph, right? But notice I draw a line, it cuts through once, draw a line here. Pretty much anywhere I draw a line on this graph, it's only gonna hit the graph one time. So for this one here, yes, it is a function. But then we need to state the domain and range of it. So when it comes to domain and range, the domain is the span of all of our x values. So if we look at this graph going from left to right, where does it exist on your x-axis? So for example, if I'm looking over here, right, so let's maybe just pick this point here. Do I have a point where my graph exists? All right, so like over here, my graph would hit here. At the x value, I have a graph here. For this one, I have it here. So this graph, again, keep in mind these two arrows right over here means that this graph is going on and on and on and on forever. So that pretty much means going left to right, my graph is always gonna be there, right? Because it just goes on and on forever. So as far as my x values are concerned, the domain is negative infinity to positive infinity because this graph is going to exist regardless where we're at on the x-axis. Take a look at the range next. So the range represents the span of our y values. So if we look up and down, do we have, or where do we have our graph in existence? All right, so going up and down, so down here I have a graph, here I have a graph, right in the middle the graph is here, up here the graph is over here. So again, remember those two arrows means that that graph is gonna stretch on and on and on forever. So this graph is gonna span everywhere. So the range for this one is negative infinity to infinity, all right? So taking a look at our next example here. So let's do a few of these and hopefully it'll make a little bit more sense here. All right, so first off, is it a function? All right, so if I can draw a vertical line anywhere on the graph and it only crosses one point, then it's a function. So if I draw a line there, hits one point, draw a line there, once. Pretty much anywhere I go on this graph, it's only gonna cross one time. So for this one, it is a yes, it is a function. Domain and range. So taking a look at our domain, going left and right. Now again, these arrows mean they're going off in either direction. So even though it's kind of curving up here, these lines are still gonna steadily widen up a little bit. So going left to right, they are gonna go endlessly on and on and on and on forever. And eventually will hit everything. So for our domain, here we also have a negative infinity to a positive infinity. When it comes to our range though, so let's take a look at that. All right, so when it comes to our range, that means we're looking up and down. And looking up and down, so I would recommend always start down and move your way up. So down here, I don't have a graph, right? This graph is never gonna turn around and go down in this direction here. So I don't have a graph until we hit this point here. So what is that point? This is a -1, 2, 3, 4. So my range values don't start until -4, and they're gonna go up and up and up and up and up to positive infinity. So for the range, we have -4 all the way up to infinity. Taking a look at this example over here, is it a function or not? So let's see, vertical line test. So I draw a vertical line on my graph and it hits here, but it also hits down there. So because it intersects at more than one point, this is a no. But let's still just look and see about the domain and range. So let's practice there. So the domain of this graph. So that's looking left to right. So going left to right, well, let's see. I don't have a graph until right over here. And that looks like a negative 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my graph starts at a negative 5, and then it's going to go all the way to this end over here, the circle, which is a positive 5. So my graph exists in the domain from negative 5 to positive 5. So that's what my domain is. For the range, now we're looking up and down. So here this graph hits also at a negative 5, and then it goes until this positive 5 right over there. So the range is also negative 5 to 5 for this one here. Taking a look at this example over here. So is it a function or not? So vertical line test, right? So again, if you draw a line anywhere on the graph, so I first drew my line right here, and it hits here, and it hits here. Now the only place that this graph would hit at one point is the very tip right there at the vertex. But the vertical line test says that if you draw a vertical line anywhere on the graph, so not just at one point, anywhere on the graph, so this is going to cross more than one time everywhere else on this graph. So this is not a function. The domain and range of this, though, so our graph starts, let's see, going left to right. It starts at this point over here, and that looks to be a negative 1, 2, 3. So the domain would go from negative 3 off all the way to positive infinity, because these lines, those arrows, mean it goes on forever. So negative 3 to infinity. Range. So range is up and down. So again, these arrows, so this parabola here is going to keep going, and eventually, slow and steady, it will hit our y values. So it's going to go off infinitely. So for our range, this will be a negative infinity to positive infinity. So then let's take a look at our last example over here. Is it a function? All right, so if we do our vertical line test, it's only going across this graph one time. So yes, this one is a function. Domain and range of it. So domain, remember, is our x values. So again, these arrows mean it's going to go off and off and off forever. So for our domain, we have a negative infinity to positive infinity. But for our range, our graph does not exist until 0, right over here. And then it's going to go off to positive infinity. So that's how you determine if a graph is a function. So do the vertical line test. And then remember, domain is the span of all your x values, range is the span of all your y values.